You can't build a wall this high. If I'm peeking through over here, you can see that steel structure that is reinforcing this wall. Otherwise, this is a lovely brickwork. It's almost, I don't know, it's almost like porn, brick porn. And Norrköping, day 3. Just checked out of the hotel, as you can see over here. Apparently we had snow last night. Let's go to see some rock carvings. Behind me is a spa, actually. Spa from Sweden. This building was built in the 1730s, so it will soon be 300 years old. Isn't that amazing? Have a look at this one. It was quite common in Sweden a long time ago to drink water from these health-giving wells. Being out in the cold means that you will have to take care of not getting sweaty. If your clothes will be a little bit wet, you will freeze much easier. So take a rest, at least 10 minutes for every hour you walk. I'm now at the rock carving place here in Norrköping. Behind me, over there, is the Motala stream or the river. And they have made this lovely information sign over here telling you everything you want to know about rock carvings. It's said to be Sweden's densest rock carving areas between Lake Glan in the west and the Bråviken Bay in the east are some 7,000 carvings. Here on these flat rocks in Himmelstalund are over 1,700 figures of ships, animals, weapons and other things. The oldest have been dated according to the swords to the early Bronze Age, about 1500 years BC, while the youngest may be 1000 years younger. The carvings have been interpreted as the remains of Bronze Age cultic acts due to the exaggerated proportions and seemingly unreal figures. The underlying purpose may have been to seek a better and happier life by calling upon the help of the gods. Other pictures are more ordinary, like herdsmen with their flocks of pigs, indicating that there is probably a mixture of everyday life and cult here. As you can see, I'm the first one today walking these paths. No one has been here before me today. Oh, great! Suddenly we get some lovely snow. Good thing I have this Gore-Tex jacket. And I also got the rain cover of my backpack. When visiting a city, I tend to head for the harbor. And I will also take a look at this lovely small island in the middle of the stream. See what it has to offer. Yes, I talked to another photographer here in Norrköping. And he said that they had actually seen beaver. That lovely little creature. Perhaps that is why they are trying to shield this tree. This really looks like a beaver has been around trying to cut down this tree. This tree is this big. I don't really know what the beaver should use this one for. Perhaps it's just doing it for fun. Look at this. They have really gone overboard with making this Christmas-like decorations in the middle of this road. And over there
even more. What a lovely set of decorations. Based on this picture, it looks like they are planning for apartments in the inner harbor of Norrköping. And it's common for many other cities in Sweden nowadays. It's quite common to see harbors in Sweden being converted into living spaces with big apartments, houses. And I guess this is because lots of freights are being transported by trucks rather than by ships nowadays. So, well, that's the history of today. We'll see in 50 years if things have changed. You never know. Apparently there are two tugs over here. I don't know if they are being used at all or if they're just here for show. And over here is a old sailing vessel that is being conserved or preserved during the winter. Another old sailing ship. This looks like it has been converted into a living space. This is the harbor of Norrköping, and this makes me a little bit sad because that means that this harbor is not being used at all. Perhaps some, but other than that it's almost empty. And that means that nothing is being produced and shipped from here. And that is of course a shame. That's how Sweden is nowadays. Yes, I made it just. They started actually at 12:54 to play this Christmas song from the bell tower here at the German square. So I'm here at City Hall again for my last 2 hours of Norrköping. And we do see a sign over here that says that Norrköping was demolished by enemies in 1567 and 1719 by fire at 1655. The city has often been raged by fire or flood, but has always, like the bird phoenix, with bigger beauty and strength, renewed itself out of fire and ash. Yes, still in Norrköping, and this is considered to be the new square. If you look behind me, these are the types of apartments that you build nowadays. Boxed houses could be seen as a little bit like wooden colors, natural colors, but I don't know. A newer type of building, I would say the 70s or perhaps even the 60s. Not that fun. And that building over there is a little bit older. I haven't seen that many statues here in Norrköping. But if you look here behind me, this is called the Prism. And unfortunately, it's not being lit up yet. Thank you, Norrköping. It was great seeing you at this time. And hopefully I will be able to come back here in the summertime.